Good morning. Yeah. I love being with this many leaders around the world from across so many different industries. And there are 6,000 of us crammed into this room here in Atlanta. But if you don't know, that's only like 3 to 5% of our entire audience today. So the rest of you watching are across one of our 750 host sites around the world. We're in 35 different countries, Kuwait, Jamaica, Thailand, Germany, and we are very honored today to have some folks gathered in various corporate headquarters tuning in today.
All we have to do is open up our eyes and hearts to those moments that can change our lives and the lives of others.
Be strong, resilient, have an audacious, bold dream for who you are and what you mean to this world.
This has been fantastic. So not only am I really enjoying the simulcast aspect of it, what I'm loving is the interaction and the dialogue with people about some of the nuggets of wisdom that are being laid out there for us today about being leaders.
My experience today at Leadercast has been actually really surprising. Initially, I thought it was going to be really boring to sit around and watch TV with a bunch of other people, but in fact, it's been really amazing. I've heard a lot of really profound statements, and I got to meet a lot of really neat people so far.
My experience with Leadercast has also been very, very awesome, and it made me want to go back to my workplace and impact my peers.
So it's just been a wonderful experience today.
Imagine a world in which all leaders took decisions not on the basis of strategic, economic, or political considerations only, but with the pure motive of doing what was right.
When danger threatens, it's the leader's instinct to cover their people. It's the leader's instinct to sacrifice themselves, their people may gain. A leader would never sacrifice their people to save the numbers. A leader would sacrifice the numbers to save the people.